Orioles 85, a whole new ball game, is brought to you in part by your nearby Nissan Datsun dealers. See one today for a Nissan test drive. And by Hardee's. Have you tasted what's making America say it's here? It's all here at Hardee's. And by Provident Bank of Maryland. For you, for now, for the future.
Well, Vince, what a difference a year makes. A year ago last spring, we were talking about a possible Orioles dynasty, and now we're talking about a disaster.
Well, 84 was a disaster. I mean, listen, we finished fifth, 19 games behind the leaders, farther back than we've ever finished since 1962, but 1985 is a whole new ballgame.
Well, that may be true in more ways than one, Vince. Of course, the start of a new season means the slate gets wiped clean. And 1985 really represents a radical departure for these Orioles, a ball club which is traditionally built from within through its farm system or an occasional trade. But this year, the Orioles have gone for something different, a quick fix.
Without a doubt, the sudden and steep fall from the heights convinced the management they'd have to go into the free agent market. And the unusual thing about this, Baltimore never been much in the free agent market, but they got the type players who fit the Oriole mold.
With the acquisition of Lynn, Lacey, and Ossie, it can only be of extreme beneficence for us.
Brother Lowe does know what he's talking about. The sudden collapse of the 84 Orioles can be summed up in two words, runs and relief. The team's run production dropped dramatically last year. In fact, the 84 Birds scored 118 fewer runs compared to the championship team. And the relief record also suffered a reversal of form, going from magnificence to mediocrity in the span of a single season. Well, the Birds figure they've found the cure to their ills with three four-letter words, Lynn, Lacey, and Ossie.
Well, I think the addition of Lacey, Lynn, and Ossie kind of put us right back into contention in our division.
In Fred Lynn, the Orioles have added to their lineup one of the game's bona fide superstars. In 1975 with Boston, he became the only player ever to win the Rookie of the Year and the Most Valuable Player of the Year awards in the same season. In 1983 with California, he became the first and the only player to hit a Grand Slam home run in the All-Star game. And now in 1985, Fred joins the third and possibly the best team he's ever played for as one of the most feared hitters in the game. And while he has already racked up some impressive career credentials, the best may indeed be yet to come. Fred will probably hit second or fifth in the order, although it's of little consequence to him.
To me, I don't really care where I hit as long as it's in the heart of the lineup somewhere where I can hurt the other club. You know, I don't want to hit eighth or ninth or somewhere down there. But if I'm in the heart of the order, I'm happy.
And the Birds will be happy not just with his bat, but with his glove. Make that gold glove. Four times Fred has won the award as the league's top defensive outfielder. And his confidence and his command in the field will be visible to all Bird watchers this year.
Although he'll be lost to the team for about a month, in Lee Lacey, the Orioles have inherited a veteran who seems to get better with age. Four times in the last 5 years, Lee has hit over 300, and last season was his best ever as he finished second in the National League batting race. Despite his hot bat, this will be Lee's first season as a full-time player.
This team is excellent for my style of play. You know, I think that I'm more valuable to a ball club that needs someone to hit number one or number two slot, and the Orioles are just perfect for my style of play.
But the Birds didn't get Lee just for his bat. They signed him for his speed as well. His base running should almost certainly lead to more Orioles runs in 1985.
Pitcher Don Ossie may be the biggest gamble of the Orioles' three free agents. In 1982, he suffered an elbow injury so severe that he needed a tendon transplant to reconstruct his pitching arm. He sat out an entire season and only returned to big league action last June. And even though he played half a season, Don's record was very impressive, so Baltimore's gamble may pay off handsomely. Don says the ordeal was tougher mentally than physically and says he's ready for his first full season in 4 years.
Certainly the Orioles bought the right pegs for the holes on the field. But what about the team's personality? There are those who worry that the influx of high-priced free agents might compromise the character of a club that is proud of its image as a team of the common man. Well, the guardians of the faith say not to worry.
They do fit the mold of Baltimore Orioles-type players. There's no big heads around here. There's no egos around here. Everyone is basically the same, although we know we have outstanding players here, but they all are treated and they act the same way.
They not only bring with them some great physical skills, but the character and the attitude of the people is just outstanding, and I think they've all fit in very well, just like they've been members of the Orioles for many, many years.
Maybe it's something about the uniform, but all three guys do sound like they were born to wear the orange and black.
The team has been a winner in the last 10, 15, 20 years, and I think that carries over to everybody that comes here. It's a more positive outlook, and everybody is, I think, especially the new guys, are anxious to get going and to keep up that tradition.
It's good now to be in a club that I know relies on pitching and defense to win instead of mashing all the time.
We got gold gloves here, we got MVPs, we got 20-game winners, we got World Series rings, so, you know, what else can you ask for when you amongst guys like that? You know, I'm just glad they're going to let me play on their team.
Well, I think Orioles fans are going to be real happy with the additions of those three players. But, Vince, I think we'd be remiss if we didn't mention a couple of guys who won't be with the club this year.
That's right, Chris. Kenny Singleton, Al Bumbry, Jim Palmer. Outstanding players.
But three of the game's finest citizens. And each of these men contributed so much to Baltimore, not only on the field in establishing the Orioles' winning tradition, but off the field as well in their service to the community.
I can honestly say I never was associated, I don't think, with three finer men. And, of course, we wish them all the very best in their new endeavors. I'll tell you, it's going to be a little tough getting along and seeing an Oriole team without Palmer and Bumbry and Singleton.
One of the unfortunate facts of life in baseball, change is inevitable. But you know, as bad as 1984 was, Vince, it could have been a lot worse without the presence of one of the game's most prolific offensive players, and I think you know who I mean.
I say one man would come to mind, and we're going to be back with him and take a look at the rest of the Oriole bats in a moment.
Nissan 300ZX Turbo. You know the car. But do you know what it's like to drive it? Now you know. Once you get inside a Z will get inside of you.
Major motion from Nissan.
For an exciting 300ZX test drive, see one of these participating Nissan Datsun dealers.
What would you like to be doing when you retire? If you're like me, you'd like to be playing golf in Palm Beach. So take it from me. Open or add to your Provident IRA now. And Provident will guarantee a great rate like this for the next 5 to 10 years. And best of all, you decide how long.
You ready, Vince?
You bet. Ready for a tax break now. And a great rate from Provident.
Provident Bank of Maryland. For you, for now, for the future.
By zillions of miles, Scotty.
Do stars get hungry?
No, Scotty, they don't.
Stars do so get hungry,
Daddy.
Especially Baltimore stars.
Very hungry. So we eat at Hardee's.
Because Hardee's is giving away Star Cups free with any sandwich, fries, and large drink purchase.
Scotty, thank the nice stars.
Thank you, stars.
1982, Diet Coke is introduced with a one-of-a-kind taste. 1983, Diet Pepsi reformulates its taste. But Diet Coke beats Diet Pepsi in taste tests across America. 1984, Diet Pepsi reformulates again to 100% NutraSweet. But Diet Coke with 100% NutraSweet beats Diet Pepsi again. 1985, Diet Coke is still one-of-a-kind, still number one. And you are going to drink it just for the taste of it.
The most productive offensive player of the 1980s wears an Oriole uniform. But more impressive than the numbers that Eddie Murray has put up has been the consistency of his production.
Yeah, and his consistency on the field, Vince, has been matched by his steadiness off the field. In fact, it's Eddie's personality as much as his productivity, which has made Eddie the quiet but undeniable leader of this Orioles team.
Long fly ball deep. Uh-oh, they're just watching that one.
There's probably no player in baseball who commands more attention than Eddie Murray. Now, of course, any player who can typically post these numbers for 8 years in a row is bound to get noticed. But the attraction goes beyond statistics. There's also the matter of style. The cool calm as he approaches the plate. The deliberate self-assurance as he steps in. It's almost as if he's offering opposing pitchers a chance to escape before the inevitable violence. Eddie's powerful presence as a player belies his soft-spoken manner as a person. And despite his dominating talent, he's reluctant to consider himself a leader.
No, I don't think of myself as a leader. And as far as being, like you say, the best on the team or whatever, here or wherever it may have been, I don't put any added pressure on me. I know I can play this game, and that's just the way I approach it. You got to have confidence in yourself, and that's one thing I got.
And Eddie's unassuming confidence has earned him the respect of teammates, old and young.
His leadership is more by example. I mean, he's the kind of guy that comes out here and has fun. I mean, you can see him laughing and joking around on the field. But once it gets down to the game time in between the lines, when it's 7:30, I mean, there's nobody out there that wants to win any more than he does.
He's a guy that I really look up to. I've always often told my mother that I wish I had a brother. And I think that, you know, he portrays that type of role because he's, you know, he's constantly on the watch and watching out for me.
Yeah, I just tried to work with him, but just tried to basically, the thing I really wanted him to understand was that everybody up here got talent. And, you know, and the thing I think that separates people is being mentally strong to play this game.
Undoubtedly, Eddie's own mental strength has enabled him to maintain his steadiness on and off the field. Last season, Eddie was voted the most valuable Oriole for the fifth time, more than any player in the club's history. But incredibly, he's never won the league's MVP. Other players might be disturbed, but Eddie typically refuses to be distracted.
It's something where I really don't particularly give it much thought. It's something I go out there and I play, and it's really nice for me to feel that the organization, the guys that I play with, the guys that I play against, know what I'm capable of doing. And that's what really matters to me. I'm going to live one way or the other, and that's just the way I look at things.
Of course, Eddie's isn't the only bat the Birds have come to count on in recent years. Last season, Cal Ripken showed the rest of the league that his MVP year in 83 was no fluke. As much as anyone on the team, Cal is hoping the Orioles can rediscover life at the top of the lineup.
Regardless of who it's ahead of you, you'd like somebody to be on base all the time. The ideal situation for a hitter, at least in my opinion, is to have people on base all the time and the opportunity to drive them in.
Cal will start 85, having played every inning of every game for the past two seasons, the longest streak of its kind in 44 years. But the shortstop says he doesn't care about records, he just wants to play.
If I feel I'm healthy enough to play and go out there and help the team, I want to play. In a game, people ask me, why don't you come out and attend enough a game when you're losing in the seventh inning? I just like going out there and playing, and I like putting on the line. I don't like sitting on the bench and watching or sitting in the clubhouse and watching it on TV. I'd rather be out there playing.
Certainly, it's in Baltimore's best interest to have Cal playing, because after Ripken and Murray, there wasn't much more to the Orioles' attack last year. The team batting average dropped 17 points and ranked 12th in the league, and our designated hitters did even worse, finishing dead last in that department. So, while the addition of Lynn and Lacey will undoubtedly help, it may not be enough. That's why a key figure in Baltimore's bid to reclaim the divisional crown will be DH Dan Ford. In 1983, Dan played a major role in the Orioles' championship campaign. Last season, he was hobbled by knee injuries, played in just 25 games, and saw his average drop nearly 50 points. Now the wheels are strong again, and Dan has been ripping the ball apart this spring.
I'm very happy to be back. You know, I guess you really just don't know how happy it is for me to be out here every day and able to do the things I'm used to doing. And it's a good feeling to come out and not really worry about my knees a whole lot, but just really contribute as far as my work is concerned to the ball club to help us win.
Another player the Orioles hope to see improvement from is outfielder Mike Young. And although he has spent time with the Orioles each of the last three seasons, this will be the first time Mike starts the year with a big club. The Orioles hope he finds his late season form from last year when he hit 12 home runs and raised his average 30 points in the second half.
Well, it's time to get out your scorecards again, because Monday the Orioles may field their six different third basemen in the last eight opening days. Wayne Gross did hit 22 home runs last year despite hitting only 216. But the man who may displace him is rookie Fritz Connolly. The Birds picked him up in an offseason minor league deal. And even though he may not look the part, everything he's done this spring has been strictly major league.
I guess you could say I'm easy going. I don't bounce up and down and all that, but I mean, I'm serious about the game. I try when I'm out there.
We didn't expect this youngster to give us the good look as he has this spring. He's done everything right with the bat, with the glove. He's looked very, very good.
Well, you can bet the Orioles are going to score some more runs this year. They're counting on the revamped lineup to revive an offense that really did collapse last year.
Oh, there's no question the offense was a disappointment. And the pitching staff, though, despite injuries to Flanagan and Tippy, nonetheless finished second in the league. But even the pitching staff has added a new look. But the guy being counted on to hold it all together is a guy who's never pitched a winning game in his life.
Every now and then you'll come across a road like this. That's when more than ever you want a car like this. The Nissan 300ZX Turbo. You flick the adjustable suspension to firm and go for it. It's your road now. And the feeling like the car is
awesome.
Major Motion from Nissan.
For an exciting 300ZX test drive, see one of these participating Nissan Datsun dealers.
Look around and you'll discover the beauty of our Maryland countryside, our Chesapeake Bay. And when you visit downtown Baltimore, you'll discover a renaissance that's continuing into the 80s. Our downtown headquarters reflects that spirit of accomplishment. The Provident Financial Center, meeting today's business and personal financial needs with a commitment to the future. Provident Bank of Maryland. For you, for now, for the future.
It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's. It's a new morning. It's a good time for two new tastes. Come on, give them a try. A fresh new breakfast made McDonald's way on buttermilk biscuits, fresh every day. Bacon, egg, and cheese biscuits. Take a big bite. A fresh baked biscuit, tender and light. Or sausage and egg, that's two new tastes. So come into McDonald's for a change of pace. New breakfast biscuits. Cause it's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's.
Already they're saving 28,000 Marylanders from high health care costs. The Free State Costbusters.
Costbusters.
Hello, Free State?
Responding to every call. Baltimore's only HMO backed by Blue Cross Blue Shield quality. Hailed for their cost busting. Relied on for the most centers in Maryland. Loved for their unlimited doctor visits and prescriptions. The Free State Costbusters. Call 828-7704 or ask your employer. And find out what all the cheering's about.
Almost as surely as the sun comes up in the east, you can bet that the Orioles will be at or near the league lead in pitching. And in a year which saw disaster at almost every turn, the Orioles at least could depend on their pitching staff in 84.
And as much as you can carry a fifth place club, the Oriole pitching staff did sustain the ball club. But despite the success they had, there's a new look to the pitching staff, and only part of that is due to design.
Really a tremendously tough year mentally for the pitching staff, losing a lot of games where they pitch great. And consequently, you spend a whole year really learning and concentrating on not making mistakes and protecting the lead or protecting a close-run ball game. You give them some runs this year and they'll know how to shut the door.
Despite the lack of runs, Orioles pitchers did perform valiantly last year. The staff ERA was second only to Detroit's, and Baltimore led the league with 13 shutouts, five of which belonged to Mike Boddicker. Hard to believe, 2 years ago, Mike started the season in Rochester. When injuries opened up a spot on the big league roster, he hopped on a rocket to stardom. Mike was the American League's only 20-game winner last year and had the lowest ERA as well.
I don't even want to match last year's goal if I can get back to the World Series. You know, I hope everybody here wins 17 and quietly get into the World Series again. You know, and no big spectacle.
Scott McGregor missed the last 5 weeks of the year, and he broke his ring finger feeling this smash. Nonetheless, he chipped in 15 wins and owns the best winning percentage in baseball over the last 6 years. And he's had one of the hottest hands in the Grapefruit League and appears to be in mid-season form.
This could be the year Storm Davis blossoms into one of the game's superstars. At age 23, he's already won 35 career games. Boddicker didn't win his first until he was 25. And while Storm's record last year was impressive enough, five of his losses were by just one run. This year, he could go over the top.
Things are looking up for Dennis Martinez, too. He developed a new off-speed pitch over the winter and has shown an improved pitch selection as well. He'll return to the starting rotation, buoyed by his continuing recovery from alcoholism, and could regain the brilliance of years past.
The addition of Don Ossie will bring some changes for the returning relief corps. For Sammy Stort, who never went longer than four innings last year, it will mean longer outings as he moves to middle relief. For resident ace Tippy Martinez, who spent much of last season suffering with a sore shoulder, the prospect of sharing short relief chores is, well, a relief.
It's definitely going to keep him strong, and it's going to keep me strong whenever I'm weak. Well, then he might be strong at one particular time, and vice versa. So knowing that the ball club is going to score some runs, if we can keep the ball club in the game, we're going to win a lot of ball games.
An off-season injury will force the O's to start the season without Mike Flanagan. But in the past, they've shown the ability to turn adversity into advantage.
Last time Palmer got hurt, we found Davis. Flanagan hurt his knee. We found Boddicker. So you start looking around, drooling at all these other guys and saying, boy, I hope there's another one of them guys in there.
This could be the guy. Ken Dixon was the top pitcher in the Southern League last year and was impressive in a pair of late-season outings with the Orioles. This spring, he's been almost untouchable, and he's convinced the Birds he's ready to fly from AA to the majors.
A man the Orioles will be counting on to hold the staff together is catcher Rick Dempsey. At age 35, Rick is the elder statesman of the Hill Corps, but he's respected not because of his age, but because he is the personification of Orioles baseball. Scrappy, courageous, and at times, stubborn.
Demper behind the plate's a tiger. You know, he loves the dirty part of the game, the defensive part of the game where he blocks balls and throws, and that's where he really takes a lot of his pride, and he's a hard worker. So he's always meant a lot to this ball club.
Really, he's a leader by intensity. That's the biggest thing. He's just so in the game and wants to do so well all the time that it kind of rubs off and it makes you want to do good too.
Indeed, as Eddie Murray is the power of this team, Rick Dempsey is its soul.
I have a game plan. I've been around most of these guys for a lot of years. I've caught them all since they've been in the big leagues. I know how they want to throw. I'm not going to go out there and tell them that they have to throw a certain pitch on me. Earl Weaver taught me that. You can't force a guy to do something or you only get a 50% effort. We have to communicate and we have to take the best that we have at that time. We have to have a happy medium somewhere in there where we can get the job done.
Rick yells at me quite a bit during a game. Nobody can see that, but I can certainly hear it.
Sometimes I get a little upset with pitchers when they pitch away from their power, when they're not doing what they're capable of doing, when they're trying to do things that they don't have control of. And I get a little upset behind home plate because we're not in tune. We're not working together. And these kind of things help lose ball games. And I'm not out there to lose ball games. I've got my amount of games is numbered at this point. And I want to make sure I win as many as I possibly can. As far as my attitude with him is concerned, I've got off of Storm a little bit. You know, I don't seem to push him as hard. I'm going to let him have the ball and let him run with it for a while and see how well he does. He's been doing pretty damn good by himself anyway. Well, I want to be remembered as an Oriole player that gave 100% all the time, no matter what. I want to be remembered as a guy who won more ball games behind home plate than any catcher in the game. That's a goal of mine, just to be a winner, I guess. And to be always remembered as the kind of person who never gave up, always gave 100%, and would do anything to win a baseball game.
Zillions of miles, Scotty.
Do stars get hungry?
No, Scotty, they don't.
Stars do so get hungry,
Daddy.
Especially Baltimore Star.
Very hungry. So we eat at Hardee's.
Because Hardee's is giving away Star Cups free with any sandwich, fries, and large drink purchase.
Scotty, thank the nice stars.
Thank you, stars.
Where can you go for 8.8% financing on top 85 trucks?
Your Nissan dealer's the one to see.
At participating Nissan dealers, 8.8% financing could save you big bucks on rugged trucks. Save up to $650 on Nissan Standard. Save up to $1,250 on King Cabs. And up to $1,350 on 4x. So for 8.8% financing, see the dealers who practically invented the small truck.
Get your best deal now at one of these participating Nissan Datsun dealers.
What would you like to be doing when you retire? If you're like me, you'd like to be playing golf in Palm Beach. So take it from me. Open or add to your Provident IRA now. And Provident will guarantee a great rate like this for the next 5 to 10 years. And best of all, you decide how long.
You ready, Vince?
You bet. Ready for a tax break now. And a great rate from Provident.
Provident Bank of Maryland. For you, for now, for the future.
Are you ready for summer? The competition is.
What? You're not ready for summer? Gained a few pounds? Well, summer's coming, and you've got to get ready. I have the solution. Holiday Spa. Join now and get summer free. Don't procrastinate. Make the commitment now, and watch how fast you see results. Why should you worry about shaping up for summer?
$18 a month for 18 months, plus the summer free. Call Holiday now.
I really, truly believe that this club is just coming into its own. I think it's going to have a period of anywhere from 7 to 8 more years of just being a dominant force in the game.
You can't blame Sparky for being optimistic. The team that wired the field is a young one, which has gotten better with the addition of pitcher Walt Terrell.
Last year, the Blue Jays lost 24 games in their opponent's final at-bat. One good reliever could have made the difference, but they've signed two with Gary Lavell and Bill Cawthon.
Those two relief pitchers have puts our club in contention right now, and a good shot at catching somebody. I think, you know, there's 4 or 5 ball clubs now that could win it, and we happen to be one of them.
For the last 5 years, Ricky Henderson has stolen more bases than his new team. The Yanks had the best record after the All-Star break last year. They'll try to finesse the field this year.
While Boston will try and crush everything in sight, the Sox starting outfield of Rice, Armas, and Evans averaged 34 homers and 116 RBIs each.
Despite such distinguished company, manager Joe Altobelli likes his team's chances.
I just feel that we're going to be competitive. I feel that our owner did a tremendous job in acquiring Lynn Lacy and Ossie for us, and I think it gave our ball club a big lift.
We'll find out how big a lift come Monday, but right now I wonder if the team could be a little depressed.
Well, of course, with Lee Lacy having had his thumb operated on today, it could be demoralizing, if nothing else.
And in a division as competitive as this one, a key injury could be more than demoralizing. It could be fatal. You picked the Tigers last year, they won. Who do you like this time?
I'll pick the Orioles this year. I think they're going to come back. They could still finish fifth and still be 2 games out, but I like them. How about you?
I think the key is Ossie and Martinez. I'll go with the O's and make it the Yankees second.
Okay.
I'm Chris Thomas.
And I'm Vince Bagley. Thanks for watching. It's been a pleasure.
Orioles 85, a whole new ballgame, has been brought to you in part by Provident Bank of Maryland. For you, for now, for the future. And by Hardee's. Have you tasted what's making America say it's here? It's all here at Hardee's. And by your nearby Nissan Datsun dealers. See one today for a Nissan test drive.
The nice thing about a...